Hi, Creality has just released the new software, Creality Scan 4, version 1.6.15. I have received this beta version of this final release about 2 weeks ago, just before the new year, and I have tested. Okay, let's see what's new in this version. First new function that you are going to notice is that they have this panel to connect to the Wi-Fi hotspot of your 3D scanner. So if you have a Wi-Fi handle or the Ferret Pro or the Otter Lite, you can connect it by using this function. Click on here and it's going to search for your Wi-Fi handle, which is this one. So I'm gonna click here. So it's going to ask you for the password. This button is in Chinese. It's a little bit easier to connect than clicking on your control panel of your Windows and connect the Wi-Fi manually. And the next feature that you are going to notice is when you scan with your mobile phone. You can click here to import the scan data from your mobile. They have a QR code here, and when you click share button in the mobile app, it's going to transfer all the projects file here automatically. I test it works for the first time, but when I try it for the second time, it didn't work. So I need to transfer the file using quick share. Every Android phone has quick share, which is a file transferring. You can transfer files between phones and from the phones to the PC. So you just need to download quick share for Windows. When you are in the same Wi-Fi network, it's going to detect a nearby device using the Bluetooth. It's going to transfer the files either by the Bluetooth or the Wi-Fi. And it's very fast and reliable. Usually when I scan a large data using a LiDAR scanner, I will transfer to my PC using this method. I can transfer 3-4 gigabytes of data very, very quickly, and it never fail. And this version of the Creality Scan 4 also support the calibration board that is made from quartz. So the version before this one, you cannot calibrate with the quartz calibration board. Okay, let's take a look at the feature that we are waiting for. There are 3 tabs now, and this tab is quick measure. When you click on this tab, it's going to show you 2 new functions for measuring the length and the angle. Before I demonstrate this function, I'm going to show you how to properly measure the distance of a mechanical part. Because if you are using the Laptus or Simoon's series 3D scanner, it's going to give you a plus or minus 50 micron of the accuracy error. So when you want to measure the distance value from the 3D scan data, you have to do it properly to be able to get this precision level of the accuracy. So I export the scan files in the point cloud format. This is the ASC file format. It's the point cloud. And I'm going to import it into a cloud compare. Okay, this is cloud compare. This is the same scan as this one, but in the point cloud format. And you can notice that I put a sticker mark here, so that it will be the point where I place my vernier caliper to measure the distance between one end to another end. This is how I run the test of the 3D scanner for the accuracy error. This part is about 150 millimeter in the length. So before I start to do the measurement, you need to align one face of your mechanical part to a flat level XY plane first. So I'm gonna click on the point cloud. Click on this 3 points alignment tools. Click on 1, 2, and 3. Okay, now this face is aligned to the XY plane. Next, I'm going to align it to the X axis. See this corner here? See X in the red color? I'm going to turn it along the Z axis using my left click on the mouse to rotate it and right click for moving it. So you can zoom in. If you have a 4K mirror, it will be very good. And rotate it along the Z-axis. You can zoom in a little bit more and use the edge of your windows to align it. Okay, now this side is aligned to the X-axis. So when you do the measurement, so you can lead the value of the displacement along the x-axis. Okay, next I'm going to measure this distance between 2 points. I can see the sticker mark here. I'm going to click on this distance measuring tools and click on here 1 point. Because I'm using the point cloud, so I can see the point that is opposite, right? Because it's transparent, I'll try to align it exactly at the same point here using my mouse to click it. So I have a very, very straight line. Okay, now you can check the accuracy of your measurement by checking the distance and the displacement is very close, right? Because I click exactly in the same spot. So the distance and the displacement will give the same reading, 150.019, and this one also 150.019. And when I use the vernier caliper to measure this, it read 150.02. So I use the Samoon X1 to measure this. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to Creality Scan 4 and try to use the new length function to measure this. You need to hold the control key on your keyboard and hold it. Do not release it. And then you use your left click to orbit to the opposite side. And because it's a mesh, you cannot see the opposite point that you have clicked. So you need to put some mark on there. Okay, so it's a little bit on here in the front. So I think it's somewhere around here. Okay, so now you have the reading. And it reads 150.019. So it is 761 micron too long from the actual dimension, from the actual distance measurement. I think there's something very long with the, you see here, something very long with the function. Always give longer distance. Let me try again. This time is 820 microns too long. It's wrong. Let me try orthographic wheel. Maybe it's a graphic wheel that give the wrong reading. 150.67. So this function, the length measurement, it will always give you the wrong reading for this length, about 600-700 microns. So if a measuring tool provides inaccurate readings in high value projects, this may lead to incorrect machining, assembly misfit, or structural weakness. So it's causing costly rework and probably you can damage your equipment. So you can do like a casual measurement, approximate plus one minus millimeter with this tool. Okay, let's move to the next function, the angle. Okay, I'm going to show you how to properly measure angle between two faces of the 3D model. The first step, I'm going to measure the angle between this face and this face. So two faces, right? First, I'm going to create a plane. Okay, this will be the first plane. This will be the second plane. So you have two planes. To measure the angle between two faces of the model, you need to use the plane. You cannot measure the angle by using the line or the point, so it has to be plane. Then I'm gonna click on here, measurement tools, and it reads 19.25 degrees. This is how you properly measure the angle between two faces of the 3D models. Now take back to Creality measuring tools. Let's check. Okay, I'm going to measure the angle between this plane and this plane, right? It has to be 90, right? It can't be anything else. Let me measure. Click on control key, and you need to do it 3 times. But most of mechanical part is not going to give you like a very sharp angle, so you need to click it somewhere in the middle here and here. So it's read 108 degrees, which is look at that, it not even snap onto the plane. The implementation of the measuring tool is wrong. To be able to measure it correctly with the high precision, first they need to fix the align model tools. They have to be able to align the model to the XY plane quicker and faster than using the gizmo to move it manually. And they have to fix the snapping tools. They need to be able to create the planes on the face to be able to measure the angle of a 3D model. You can use 3 points to measure the angle of a 2D flat drawing, but not the 3D models. This is really surprised me that they release a non-functional function of the software to the public. Okay, that's it for this new Creality Scan 4 1.6.15. At least they can call themselves they have a measuring tool, but it doesn't work, and I do not recommend any of you to use it. Thanks you guys for watching. I see you in the next video.